Hey, Queens County, we're zooming around the county today, and we're talking with Theresa Worden from Maryland Humanities, and we're talking about Voices and Votes, Democracy in America, a great exhibit coming to Queens County in the near future. Welcome, Theresa.
Hi, thanks for being here.
Yeah, of course. This is a pleasure. It's nice to meet you today and talk with you and talk about this amazing event that's coming up. Can you tell us what Voices and Votes is all about?
Voices and Votes, Democracy in America is an exhibit that travels. It's based on a large exhibit at the American History Museum in DC. And what it will be doing in April is traveling around the state, allowing small communities to host it and have discussions around it. There will be programming and opportunities to discuss what it means to have a voice in our democracy.
Right. And I don't think there's any time better than right now to talk about votes and voices, because we just had our election, obviously. And so many people have been heard, but we had a record amount of people interested in voting. So it's really cool to have this exhibit coming at this time.
Yeah, it's a very relevant. And I think a lot of people will be ready to talk about what democracy means to them.
So what kind of things will be in these exhibits?
Well, the Smithsonian has a lot of resources. And what they've done is they've taken a 2,000 square foot exhibit and distilled it down into an exhibit that occupies about 600 square feet. So it's really condensed, but it does cover about five content areas. One is dedicated to really looking at what that leap of faith was when our forefathers declared independence, from Britain. It also covers, the machinery of democracy, which means how our founding fathers set up democracy so that we could have a functioning government. But really, it's interesting because some of the other areas really talk about and get into what it means to have a voice in our democracy. So not just through voting, but also through how we represent ourselves, whether it be through protests and civil disobedience. And so those things are important because not everybody can vote. I'm talking about those who are underage, maybe under 18, they can't vote, but they certainly have a right to voice their opinion and shift the tide, so to speak.
Let's talk about Queens County, because they're one of the communities that you selected. So that's coming in June 12th, right?
That's right. It's the first time Museum on Main Street is coming to Queen Anne's County. So we're excited to bring the exhibit there, especially this particular one.
Yeah, and we were talking right before that it's important to come to the small communities across the bridge because people don't always get to make it to DC, or people are afraid to drive across the bridge, right?
That's right. Yeah, Museum on Main Street really is this amazing outreach program that the Smithsonian Institution runs because they recognize that they have a lot of resources and not everybody can get to DC to visit the museums. So they want to bring these small exhibitions to us out here in small and far away regions.
Right. And when people come and you have the displays out, are they going to be like touch screens where you can go through information and videos they can watch, stuff that they can read, stuff like that?
Yeah, it's very interactive, actually. It's an exhibit, as I said, that takes up 600 square feet, but it includes videos and touch screens, interactives, the nice flip books or the spinning interactives, the ones that are analog, not really on screen.
Right.
But it's also going to include a story kiosk, which will contain, short recordings of people just telling their own stories about what it means to vote or what it means to be a citizen to them.
Right. And this wonderful exhibit is coming to Queens County again, June 12th. It's being brought from the Smithsonian to us by you at Maryland Humanities. So please tell us about Maryland Humanities a little bit before I let you go.
Maryland Humanities is a nonprofit. We produce informal educational activities across the state. That means that we use the humanities lens to help explore what it means to be human and how we connect with one another. We do programming such as the Museum on Main Street, but also Maryland History Day and One Maryland, One Book. We also provide grants to organizations so they can do their own programming using the humanities. So definitely check us out.
Yeah, definitely. And we had a wonderful conversation about One Maryland, One Book. And there's so much that we could keep talking about, but we want to focus on just one thing today. Maybe we'll bring you back in the future to talk about those things.
That would be fabulous.
Wonderful. Well, we look forward to seeing you in June. I'm sure we're going to talk again once it arrives. And in the future, for more details, we will be doing more videos. So please look out for them. But thank you, Theresa, for joining us today. And we look forward to Voices and Votes, Democracy in America, coming to Queen Anne's County.